Nico Satomura and Maleo Hosaka. It's been quite a while since we've seen Maleo Hosaka, but there is young Nico Satomura, another teenager from the country of Japan who has made quite an impact, and they love her.
Well, hey, Rod Stewart made it.
You're not funny. And she's going to face the veteran Maleo Hosaka, who we know quite well, who's been competing in this country, and is from Tokyo, and she's quite a competitor, Bray.
And she's a beautiful, beautiful dish.
Yes, she is. She is a beautiful lady. And but she's got an attitude, and of course, for you, beauty and attitude.
That's not her, that's Sonny Ono.
Well, we know that. And here is Maleo Hosaka.
Look at those feathers.
Look at those feathers.
Makes you want to go duck hunting, don't it?
No, it doesn't.
Quack, quack.
But Hosaka is beautiful and quite a competitor as well. And she and Satomura in this one-on-one matchup. And immediately Hosaka, who certainly has the ring experience advantage, goes for the attack.
Yeah, no time wasted here. Japanese people are business people. They know to win a match, you got to beat somebody. So let's get it over with. Let's show the Americans how good we are.
Satomura with a cross body. And here's a problem we saw with her a couple of weeks ago. She does a lot of cheerleading, and that's an inexperienced mistake. There's a knee right to the throat. And a drop kick. Attacking Hosaka again. Satomura.
Oh!
How about that?
What a dish.
Reverse standing sidekick. Hosaka reversal. Satomura again, reckless abandon. And a forearm shot to the throat.
Who's screaming? Is that you?
No, that's her.
Which one is her?
Satomura. Yeah, she's full of herself. She's going up top.
And she's doing all the screaming.
Yes, she is.
Maybe she got a pair of shoes that fit. It wouldn't happen.
Oh! That's a major upset.
That certainly is.
The youngster, the teenager, with an upset over Maleo Hosaka. And you saw it right here on Worldwide. And she's enjoying this. And that's a big win. I mean, that's the biggest win of her career. And we were all a part of it, Brain.
Well, she seems to be very, very happy. Very, very happy. Let's get another look at it. Shoots her opponent into the corner. Takes it right in the mouth. I thought she had it there. I thought it was over there. But no, look at the elevation off that top rope. And there's your winner, the teenager, the young lady from the rising sun.
Nico Satomura is your winner. Celebration begins for her. I know, and Mike knows, that the giant is no long, tall drink of water.
Absolutely not.
Yeah, for crying out loud.
He's the largest athlete in professional sports.
Nico Satomura.
Thank you, Mike.
Is making her way out here. Mike is joining us because we are beginning a tournament for a brand new title in WCW, Mike.
Yeah, Tony, it's the WCW Women's Cruiserweight title. This matchup, first round action involving Meiko Satomura. Her opponent is Toshie Oematsu. And we will have another first round Women's Cruiserweight tournament matchup this weekend on TBS, involving Kato against Maleo Hosaka. Now, the men's cruiserweight division here in World Championship Wrestling has set an awfully high standard. We're going to find out if the women can match their success.
Well, we have seen some great things out of the women's heavyweight division. And there's a good look at Uematsu. And there's the ladies' cruiserweight belt. Mickey J, the referee, holding it up.
The men's cruiserweight weight limit set at 230 pounds. And the women's at 130 pounds. Oh, dropkick right off the belt from Uematsu. Of course, Akira Hokuto, also of Japan, in possession of the women's heavyweight title in World Championship Wrestling.
A title that she will defend here tonight. And the winner will go on to Frank Stampede to meet Medusa.
Tough training regimen that the Japanese women wrestlers must complete before they become pros. Thousands try out each year, and just a handful make the grade.
Well, we got the same thing at the power plant. There's a million wannabes and only one survivor.
Well, you know.
Which one's the one in the green?
That is Uematsu.
Okay, now we're getting somewhere.
And Satomura loves to call out and look out to the fans here.
Yeah, but that's a waste of time. I don't care. Even if you got your opponent hurt, zero in. Don't waste those precious seconds.
Scoop slam with ease that time, and Satomura going to go up top now.
Both of these young ladies, of course, associated with the Gaia promotion in Japan. It's a sister promotion to WCW in the Orient, much like the working agreement that we have with New Japan Pro Wrestling for the men.
See, that's the product of wasting too much time. What's the one in the red?
Satomura. Don't you do your homework? Look at your format.
I'm looking at the format.
Okay, into the corner. And Uematsu springs off that time, but I think the effect was felt. Here she goes again.
Tried a second time.
Walks right up her. How about that? You don't see that every day.
Both of these young ladies, very little experience in the ring compared to, say, Akira Hokuto and Medusa, the top stars in the women's heavyweight division, both in their third year as pros. Satomura in the red climbs the top rope. She is 20 years of age, and Uematsu down on the mat is 23.
Yeah, they do start at a very young age. The ladies in Japan. How about that? An arm drag over the top rope.
And the open hand head slap prior to that that apparently knocked the equilibrium off Satomura.
Up on top now, Uematsu. Just wasting time. Big one night flag. Two and three. That's a big win for her.
Yep, the one in the green won it.
Very good. The one in the green won it, according to Larry Zbysko. And for Uematsu now, she will go on now and advance in this tournament to crown the very first ladies cruiserweight champion in World Championship Wrestling.